And I'm Gene Cox in for Bob Donaldson tonight. Today, we started with a question referencing a Fox 59 investigation. Our Russ McQuaid first reported this past weekend that a top commander who was reassigned for not keeping his bosses informed actually made several phone calls to the higher-ups from the scene that day. Where was the mayor in all this? Apparently, for a while at least, left out of the detailed loop. Those kind of details, how could the mayor not know?
Well, I mean, there's a lot of things going on in the city at any one time. I get briefed, obviously, by those who report to me. So that was part that, frankly, I did not get briefed on. It's really nothing more than that.
You refer in your book to the junior answering to the senior.
Mm-hmm.
Is that what we have in the police department?
It all stops with me. The buck stops with me. It does.
Is Dr. Straub the senior in the chart of responsibility?
Well, the top cop is clearly Chief Soselsky, all right, and Dr. Straub oversees everybody. But those two are working together to do those reforms that I've talked about.
No struggle there?
I don't think between them two, those two, no, not whatsoever.
In your mind, as we stand here today, will the key players still be in place at the end of this investigation?
I don't know. I mean, we have to see. I mean, I like who we have right now, but we need to make sure. That's why you have an independent investigation.
Have you lost faith in the chief and in Dr. Straub and their ability to lead?
No, because they were brought in for the reform. I mean, that's the whole point. Now, we're in the middle of this crisis, clearly, and people are saying, how about this, how about this, how about that, and I understand that. But right now, we will get through this. I want the correct facts. Got to have the correct facts. And then we'll decide from then on how we go forward.
The mayoral candidate Gibson has said, you know, called this a botched investigation. Do you agree?
An unthinkable misjudgment by Officer Bisard, one that resulted in a preventable and a deadly accident.
Well, I use that word myself. That's what it looks like initially. We'll see as we go forward. And I got to tell you, I'm just being honest here, and I know probably people don't want me to say this, but people who are using politics for this tragedy, I just think that's shameful. I do. I really do. And it really bothers me on either side. And this is a tragedy. We have three families that are really hurting right now, and people are using politics for it. And that's not who I am. That's not what I'm going to be.
They're using it as an opportunity to say, well, you promised us a better, swifter, smoother police department, and now we have this.
Well, you can say that all you want, but we also brought in to bring in better reforms over the long haul. And like I said before, you can't flip a switch. You just can't do that. There are things that need to be done, things that have been ignored for a long time, and we have been addressing them.
Does this prove that ignorance over those years?
Well, the funny thing is, we're the ones exposing this. I would suggest to you some of the stuff that we've been exposing might not have been exposed in the past. We didn't cover it up. It's all out there, and we've been very transparent about everything we've been doing, not only in public safety, but in other areas. When I wake up in the morning, this is on my mind. I mean, this is pretty much all I think about right now. And the families are on my mind, obviously. And we will continue to be open and transparent.
Does it continue to be a bruise on the city's image?
This was completely senseless. It just was. It's completely senseless.
Mayor Ballard has written letters to each of the families of the injured motorcycle riders and several letters to the family of the man who was killed, Eric Wells. During Mayor Ballard's election campaign, he often referenced a book he wrote about leadership, and he routinely said how he thought voters expected a mayor to make public safety job number one. It's clear from our interview the mayor is not ready to say that Chief Paul Soselsky and Dr. Frank Straub are the public safety leaders of the future. But he says they will be until the Bisard investigation is complete. That, he says, is job one now. Vanchin?